Okay, here, as you can see, there is a bagan of short functional text, and there are notice, labels, invitation, letter, announcement, greeting card, brochure, short message, and manuals. So we will explain to you guys about short functional text.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, this is Fitria Indriani. I am from Short Functional Text Group. I will explain the part of short functional text. I have a notice. What is a notice? Notice is a symbol or text to inform or instruct people to do or not to do something. The function of notice is to guidance or prohibition notifies people not to do something. For example, if you are going to the mall, there is a notice like warning, no smoking. It's example of notice. And the next, I have a label. What is a label? Label is a piece of paper, a cloth, or similar material that is attached to something to identify or describe it. Another definition of a label is something used to describe a person or thing. An example of a label is a piece of fabric sewn into the color of a shirt given the size, what the shirt is made of, and where the shirt was made. An example of a label is a father introducing one of his sons as the smart one. Now, however, a label, if in business definition, is to use to provide information about a product or service offered by your company. I think that's all about my part of short functional text. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello guys, my name is Nur Pendrianti. Okay, in this part, I will explain about the invitation and greeting card. Okay, invitation is the act of giving someone to go to the event. Okay, for the example is all of children grade 12, you are invited to graduation party 2016 SMAN 1 Y Bunur. Okay, the date is Saturday 12 March 2016, time 10 past p.m. until 30 past p.m. Okay, venue ballroom Citra 2 Hotel, Jalan Street Tawas Kau 10 until 13 Y Bandur. Come and join us. Okay, invitation card are available at the office room. Okay, for the last part is greeting card. Okay, a greeting card is a folded card with a picture on the front and greeting inside that you give someone. Okay, for example is Dear Teddy Pramata, okay, wish you many happy return of the day. My God bless you with health, wealth, and prosperity in your life. Okay, happy birthday, love from Dia. Okay, maybe enough for me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hi, my name is Putri Yulinda Sari. Here, I am going to explain one of short functional text, that is letter. Jadi di sini saya akan menjelaskan salah satu bagian dari short functional text, yaitu surat atau letter. So, as you can see from this flowchart here, one part of short functional text here is letter. Jadi bisa dilihat dari bagan arus yang ada di sini, salah satu bagian short functional text adalah letter atau surat. And from this, we can see the definition of letter. Letter is written message that can be handwritten or printed on paper. Jadi dari sini kita bisa melihat definisi dari letter atau surat. Jadi surat itu adalah pesan tertulis yang mana ia bisa dalam bentuk tulisan tangan atau dalam bentuk cetak.
Benar banget.
You can choose whichever you prefer. From the definition alone, letter is a written message. So it means that letter contains message that needs to be delivered in written style. It can be either in the form of handwritten or printed out. Ya. Jadi dari definisi ini sendiri, letter atau surat itu adalah pesan tertulis. Nah, maksudnya ialah letter atau surat itu mengandung pesan yang disampaikan dalam bentuk tulisan. Bisa menggunakan bentuk tulisan tangan ataupun dalam bentuk cetak. And now, let's move. Ya, sekarang kita lanjut. Here, I have the example of letter. As you might already know, letter can be divided into two kinds: formal letter and informal letter. Di sini saya sudah sediakan contoh letter atau surat. Jadi surat itu dibagi menjadi dua jenis, ada surat yang jenisnya formal dan surat yang jenisnya informal. And formal letter is the type of letter that is written for formal situation, just like for institution or office matters, for example. Jadi surat formal itu adalah surat yang ditulis untuk situasi formal, kayak surat dari institusi atau dari kantor. While informal letter is the type of letter that you usually write with ease to your friends, to your parents, to your relatives, and so on. Unlike formal letter, informal letter does not follow strict rules in the writing style and you can use whatever language you want. Jadi berbeda antara surat formal dan informal. Kalau formal untuk institusi, kalau informal itu bisa untuk orang tua, teman, dan sebagainya. Here I have the example of the letter. Di sini saya sudah sediakan contoh surat. Okay. We have date here. As you can see, Palangkaraya, 7 March 2018. And then year, Dwi, blah, blah, blah. So it is easy to determine whether a letter is either formal or informal. Sebenarnya mudah ya untuk menentukan apakah suatu surat atau letter itu jenisnya formal atau informal. We can see from the word dear Dwi or dear blah 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 blah. Besides, the content of the letter is about private life. So it can be determined that this letter is informal letter. Jadi kalau misalkan kita pengen menentukan surat itu apakah formal atau informal, ya, dari contoh ini kita bisa lihat ada kata dear, bla bla bla. Kemudian jenis kontennya itu lebih banyak membicarakan tentang kehidupan pribadi. And so, that is from me. We will continue to the other part of short functional text. See ya, bye!
Hello everyone, my name is Faridianian Salujia. Then for the next part is about brochure and short message. Alright, so for the first is brochure. Brochure is informative document that can be folded into template, pamphlet, or leaflet. For example, like food template, and usually you can see some information on the template, like price, promotion, address, or some product that promote in the advertisement. For the second is about short message. It's the way to sending a short written or short message from the one for mobile to another or from someone to another people.
Okay, I'm Vina Putika Normalsari and I will explain about announcement. Okay, so here there is a short functional text and I will explain about an announcement. And for the definition, a formal written notice of certain events which has happened or going to happen. And for the example is, as you can see here, there is an example of announcement. School trip to Pahawang Island. On 23 of March, the school will hold a school trip to Pahawang Island. And for the departure time, on 7 a.m. And for the program, in the morning, there can swimming, snorkeling, and lunch in the sea, and play some games, and then volleyball. And for the afternoon, walk along in the beach to the Mahitam and watch the tower. And for the fee, 170,000 rupiah. And for the contact person is Janet and Miko, and chairperson is Budi Wah.
Okay, the next is manual. So manual is an introduction for you to operate a certain product. As we can see here, the example is how to use Realme smartphone. Jadi manual merupakan sebuah teks yang berisi tentang bagaimana cara menggunakan atau mengoperasikan sebuah alat. Manual biasanya banyak kita temukan pada berbagai jenis alat elektronik atau alat lainnya yang baru saja kita beli. Karena biasanya manual ini disertakan dengan alat yang kita beli sebagai panduan untuk menggunakan atau mengoperasikan alat tersebut.